한 만여 명 이상의 북한군이 러시아에 지금 가 있고 그중에서 상당수가 크루츠크를 포함한 전선 지역으로 이동한 것으로 저희가 파악하고 있습니다.
세부 재원은 종합적으로 분석하고 있고 그 평가도 병행하고 있습니다.
We believe that there are now at least 10,000 DPRK forces in the Kursk Oblast, recognizing that as we continue to assess DPRK presence on the ground, those numbers could go up slightly in terms of the total number of DPRK troops in Russia. We've seen the press reports about alleged combat ops. We're looking into those, but at this point cannot corroborate those reports. But as you heard Secretary Austin say last week, should these troops engage in combat support operations against Ukraine, they would become legitimate military targets.
You said that there's a bandwidth between those in Kursk.
But as we look at those numbers, we think that the total number of DPRK forces in Russia total could be closer to around 11 to 12,000, with about 10,000, at least 10,000 right now in the Kursk Oblast. Okay.
Senior Ukrainian officials have said that they are observing.
Well, North Korean troops being deployed in Russia against Ukraine, this is a significant escalation, and it makes us even more focused and determined to make sure that Ukraine has what it needs to fight off the Russians, including the North Koreans. And then on North Korea, we are working closely, as you know, with the Indo-Pacific partners, of course, with the Republic of Korea, so South Korea, Seoul, but also with Japan, with Australia, with New Zealand, to make sure that we are able to also with this new development to do everything we can to keep not only the Euro-Atlantic, but also the Indo-Pacific safe. We know that Russia is working here together, not only with North Korea. China is providing dual-use goods and is helping with sanctions circumvention. And of course, we know that Iran is involved in helping Russia with the war effort. So this motivates us to step up, to do even more.
As a former prime minister, I know that it is not always easy for governments.
And on the American elections, whoever wins those elections, we will work with Kamala Harris, we will work with Donald Trump, and make sure that the alliance stays united. I have no doubt, because it is in our interest. It is in our interest here, but also the United States, because they are not in this to not repeat the mistake after the First World War or withdrawing from Europe. No, they are in this because they know that if Putin would be successful in Ukraine, that at that moment an emboldened Russia is on our eastern flank and will present a direct threat to NATO territory.
regret that you were able to visit Seoul before the end of your term to co-chair with me the first ever speech. Good evening.
Once again, very happy to be in Korea again.
Thank you. You are a great delegation. It's indeed great to see you again after our first meeting.
The dialogue comes at a critical juncture as the deepening military cooperation between North Korea and Russia poses a serious threat to the security of Europe, in the Pacific, and indeed the world at large. This strategic dialogue, therefore, offers a timely and crucial platform for us to further coordinate our responses to such great challenges and to renew our dedication to global peace and stability.
Thank you for your condolences. I thank you for your... It's not a rhetorical, it's not a theoretical approach. It is because the war is at the borders of Europe, and it is because in this war, North Korean troops are going to participate. So this increases the need for us to work together. To work together guided by common interests and shared values, and with the will to strengthen our efforts to show that democracies deliver best for our citizens.